Hey guys, it's KEVINVANDY, and CyberLink has again just released another iteration of PowerDirector. This time we're up to version 16. Now this is mostly going to be just a first look and impressions video, and I'll mostly be going over all the new features and changes that are unique to this version of PowerDirector. So this video might be geared towards those of you who have just used PowerDirector before, and maybe you're considering upgrading to this new version. If you are new to PowerDirector or have never used it before, check the description and I'll link a video of a more complete review of Power 16 that I'm going to make after using this for about a month. Anyway, with that out of the way, let's get started going over the software. Now in this new version of PowerDirector, you won't find many big, new, shiny features as many of the previous versions of PowerDirector have traditionally introduced. Instead, there are numerous small improvements that improve the overall workflow and editing experience within PowerDirector. Some of these tweaks are quite visible, while others are under the hood for making PowerDirector faster, smoother, and overall just a more stable experience. Now, starting with the improvements under the hood, the RAM usage on startup seems to have improved dramatically. If I look over at my task manager, you can see that it's only using 116 megabytes on startup here. I just opened it, and that's actually really low. I mean, it seems to be about a fourth of what PowerDirector 15 was using. I'll show you a chart here. As you can see, PowerDirector 16 is actually using, on average, about a third of the RAM that PowerDirector 15 was using on startup. Now, that actually all kind of changes as soon as we actually start editing. Like, if I bring a clip down here, and maybe another image, and then we look at the task manager again, we see it going back up to normal, although that's actually still pretty low, 200. Usually when I'm working with PowerDirector, it's usually getting close up to about a whole gigabyte of memory. That's usually when I'm doing a little bit of a larger project. But anyway, that's pretty nice to see. Now looking at another under-the-hood improvement, or at least one that CyberLink claims, CyberLink upgraded their rendering engine to True Velocity 7. However, after some testing, I couldn't find much improvement to show, except maybe for the H.265 option, which showed a tiny bit of improvement. Now moving on, the focus, as far as new visible features go for PowerDirector 16, seems to mostly be the inclusion of more color grading tools inside of PowerDirector itself. Now I say inside of PowerDirector itself, because CyberLink also has another piece of software called ColorDirector, which comes with the more expensive versions of PowerDirector, such as the Director Suite package or your subscription plan. Now it seems that they are bridging the gap between the two a bit, or at least they're importing some of the more basic features of ColorDirector into PowerDirector itself. Now the feature that I find most impressive is the new Color Match feature. And what this helps you do is it keeps the color grading of your entire video more consistent throughout your entire project. So for example, let's say you shot some footage in the morning, but then as you kept shooting, the sun changed position or started getting more cloudy or less cloudy, but you want all the video clips that you shot to look like it was shot in exact same weather and exact same time of day. With Color Match, you can kind of correct the colors to make all your clips kind of look the same. So that can be pretty useful. Now they have also added tabs for split toning, which lets you change the color grading for the highlights and shadows of the video clip separately. And they've added another tab called the HDR effect, so this will make the footage that you shot look like it was shot with HDR, or just improve the HDR effect. And they also have a new lookup table feature where you can import a color lookup table. And of course, they also have the color presets, and they say they have improved this, where you can just, with one click, you can make your video look like one of these presets. So this is just a really easy way to get some color grading with just one click. And I think I should also mention that the normal color adjustment and color enhancement tabs are still here too. Now, just one more small thing to mention here. If you remember last year, PowerDirector's big new feature was the new 360-degree video editing capability. PowerDirector is still one of the only few video editors that actually support editing 360 video. So now it's improved a bit. Now there's actually support for video stabilization in 360 video, so you can make your 360 videos look a little bit smoother. Otherwise, the view designer for 360-degree video is mostly still the same. I don't know if they had object tracking last year, I think they did. But anyway, that does it for all the major big features of PowerDirector 16. Now to wrap things up, there are a few minor, minute changes that there are in PowerDirector 16. For one, that might confuse a few people, they've kind of redone how you adjust audio in video tracks. Now, when you drag this bar, it changes the volume for an entire clip. If you want one part of a video to get quieter, you have to hold the control button. Then that's how you get back to the old behavior. Also, of course, looking for media and sorting your media library has just gotten a little bit better. You can view your media in details mode now, so you can see all the statistics and whatever about your videos, or helps you find your videos more, especially if you have a ton of videos in your media library. You got shortcuts for just going switching between small and large icons, and etc. Anyway, that's gonna pretty much do it for this video. Now I gotta say, when I first started using PowerDirector 16 for review, I wasn't actually that impressed with it at first. But as I started using it more and more, I actually started to notice all the small improvements do seem to add up, and it makes a nice upgrade. For those of you who stuck around to the end of the video here, notice that the first link in the description will take you to the CyberLink website where you can buy PowerDirector 16 for yourself. Also, you can apply the coupon code KEVINVANDY for 12% off your purchase. And just a quick disclaimer, those links are affiliate links, meaning that I may make a small commission if you buy PowerDirector through one of those links. So if you do want to buy PowerDirector, you can use those links to get 12% off to help both yourself and me. I also include a second link that will take you to the comparison page, where you can see the differences between the Ultra, Ultimate, Ultimate Suite, Director Suite, whatever. But I personally recommend that you should just get the Ultra version, because as you will see, each of those versions are actually just the same exact PowerDirector. The only differences are that the more expensive ones include more titles, effects, and transitions, and other stuff like that. You can actually download more stuff for free from the director zone, so I always just get the Ultra version. Anyway, hope you guys have a great day. Subscribe if you want to see my new PowerDirector tutorial series I'm currently making. I've already got a few videos waiting to upload. And comment below if what you think of the new release of PowerDirector.